I'm Matthew Burchette, and this is Behind the Wings!
Wait, somebody turn this thing off!
Okay, so silliness aside, this episode is actually on the F-100 Super Sabre. Ours is a D model. Now, the F-100 first hit the Air Force in 1954, and it was actually to be a replacement for the F-86 Sabre, which had gained fame in the Korean War. So let's do a walk around on this baby and see what's what. One of the reasons we really like our F-100 is because it's just cool looking. I love this green tail, and that represents the 356 Tactical Fighter Squadron of the 354th Tactical Fighter Wing when they were based in Italy in 1960 during the Berlin Crisis. And our aircraft actually was there, and it was painted just like this. But enough of that. Let's go check out the cockpit. That's where the good stuff is. So here we are in the front office, the main office of the F-100. And as you can see, we've actually got quite a bit of the instruments left in here. Now, one of the really cool things that a lot of people don't know about the F-100 is that some of them were equipped with what was known as LABS, and that stood for Low Altitude Bombing System. And at the time, that was a big deal because it was computerized and it would work with your autopilot. Now, what LABS was is that if you were going to deliver a nuclear weapon, you want to be out of there before that thing goes off. Well, this guy wasn't fast enough to really get you out of there, so LABS was a way for a pilot to come over the target at very low altitude, pull straight up, launch the bomb, pull away, and let that bomb come over an arc and right back down on the target. So one of the other cool things, this little guy right here, drag chute. But not only did we have a drag chute, we had something even better. What makes a Navy plane a Navy plane? Bam! A tail hook. Wait, F-100's not a Navy plane, but it still has a tail hook. Remember that little handle we saw in the cockpit for drag chute? Well, what if your drag chute doesn't fully slow you down? This little guy sure will. So what this is it's actually a tail hook just like a Navy plane, but this one is not designed for use all the time. If you're screaming down the runway and your brakes don't work and your drag chute isn't slowing you down and you're about to hit that perimeter fence, this little baby will stop you real fast. So what you do is you pull a handle, bam, this comes flying down, hits the pavement, and then drags along until you hit that arrestor wire, and then woof, you are stopped, baby. Now, one of the cool things about the F-100, other than it looks just awesome, is that it took part in what they called Zelle Experiments. And a Zelle stood for a zero-length launch. They would strap a huge rocket right here, and the aircraft would be put in a cradle, and then the rocket would literally launch it off the cradle. Now, why do you do that? Well, in the 1950s, when this guy was first designed, we were really terrified by Soviet ICBMs and bombers. So the idea was is that if you could put a bunch of fighter aircraft on a mobile launcher, you didn't need a very vulnerable airfield. So you could station these aircraft all around like a missile site or say a nuclear facility, and they could get into the air much quicker with a Zelle than they could taking off from a runway and having to get to speed and climb to altitude. And so the F-100 was one of these aircraft that we actually tested. Never went any further really than the testing phase, but it sure looks cool. All right, so here we are kind of at the wingtip of the F-100's right wing. And you'll see off to my left here is this kind of fence-looking thing. Well, guess what that's called? A wing fence. No kidding. Now, why on earth would this have this? Well, because the Sabre actually has a really bad tendency to pitch up. And as they would come in at a low speed, and sometimes even at a high speed, the air, instead of going from front to back over and under the wing, would start to kind of move to the side and to the middle of the aircraft. In fact, it was so bad, it actually got its own name, the Sabre Dance. Well, as engineers figured this out, they came up with this super technical way to stop it, the wing fence. And all it does is act like a normal fence where the air hits it, stops, and then it automatically goes to the back again like a normal wing. And that's how they stop the Sabre Dance. Not bad. All right, so here we are at the wing again. But why are we at the wing again? Because of this bad boy right here. How cool is this thing? All right, well, it's not that cool, but it's still cool. But what is it? It's called a leading edge extension, or a LEX. And the F-100 had them because it had a laminar flow wing, which is great for going fast, not really good for going slow. So the leading edge extension would deploy when you are landing or taking off to give you more lift. That's pretty cool. So you know how on Behind the Wings we like to show you guys stuff that nobody else gets to see? That's what this is. This is a little known modification to the F-100D, which is what our plane is. This is a chin-up bar for the pilot when he was on alert. All right, I'm lying. It's actually a pitot tube. Now, what exactly is a pitot tube? Well, in this case, just a really long tube that measures fluid velocity. All right, nerd alert. In this case, the fluid is air. Air is a fluid. Don't believe me? Google that stuff. Anyway, why is this one so long? Well, you want to get this thing way out in front of that giant hole behind me, which is sucking in all that air, so you get undisturbed air, so you get a good reading for your airspeed and all those other things that are really super important to fly. What an awesome episode. Thanks for tuning in. All right, if you've got questions or comments, make sure to post them on our Facebook or our YouTube site and we'll get to them. And as always, we'll see you around.